Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Nicholas Bayerle and this is my wife,
Amanda Bayerle.
And this episode is going to be all about relationship advice from us. Now, you've probably seen a lot of me, but you may not have seen a ton of Amanda, so I'm excited for her to be here because she's the brains behind the operations inside of our company and also was the reason why I got pushed to do the things that I'm doing. And I truly believe the definition of a power couple for the people that are out there is not just to get relationship advice, because advice can only take you so far, but it's actually two people coming together with two different visions to create one like-minded vision where we use our skills, talents, and abilities to be able to get to that core vision. And just that in itself, just looking at that, like two things, creating one vision, and we're both working together, already right that there, like eliminates tons of strife. Maybe you're like a woman out there, and a man can speak to that, where you're looking at your husband, or looking at your boyfriend, or looking for a boyfriend or husband, but you're looking at them and you're like, man, like, they're doing all these things and I don't know why, and I don't understand why they're doing it, I'm not involved with it. Or the opposite, maybe you're man watching and you're like, why don't they understand it? And yeah, it's so crazy how like the same actions, right, honey? Like the same actions that a guy can do without the intention being known can be really bad. And then when the intention's known and there's a like-minded vision, all of a sudden they can be really amazing.
Yeah, I think that it's sad to see, because a lot of times we don't understand each other's motives and we assume things as well in our significant other. But I know we wanted to make this video all about relationship advice and just kind of sharing with you guys some of the things that we have learned. We have been married for 7.5 years. It'll be 8 years this May, which is really exciting. We have a little bub on the way. He will be here in a month.
I know, it's crazy.
Which is so crazy. So Nicholas, I want you to dive into what's one of the things that you think that has catapulted our success in our marriage to be even happier at, you know, married for 7.5 years, when most couples are, I mean, we know a lot of couples that have gotten divorced already, which is super sad. And you know, just ones that really aren't thriving.
Yeah. So I'll share my perspective and then we'll have Amanda share her perspective as well, so we get both sides of it. Yet I think one of the biggest things for me in particular is the fact that when we were getting together, like when we were dating, we were in the intention that we were going to get married first off. Like in the dating stage, we already had this great intention. I think one of the best things that we did is we took a premarital course together. And this was really cool, just because even if you are a really good fit to be together, it's nice to know that that's confirmed. And that way that you don't, in the future, when things get rough or some type of like rocky moments, you're not thinking back like, are we compatible? Was this something smart to do? Because that course that we took, 50% of people were actually broke up, even though we were all engaged. So this was like, you're engaged, you took a premarital course, and 50% of people broke up. I think it was around 30% of the people outside of that actually waited to get married, and then 20% continue where their due date. And one of the big things was a compatibility test. And in this compatibility test, it really shared, what's your guys' visions? And so one of the big things that we did together was we really got clear on our visions. And again, if you're already married, I believe that there's like a reason that happened and you can create that vision together. But this was just something to figure out, like, are you even compatible? And so in these questions, it'd be like, how many kids do you want to have? Do you want to travel? Are you a homebody? You know, what are the desires that you have? Are you high risk, low risk? All these different things. And what we found is a lot of people are like, I want to travel my whole life. And the other person's like, I want to stay home all the time. And then they're like, oh my gosh, we're not compatible. Like, this is very interesting. And for us, we were highly compatible. And that was really cool to be able to see right off the bat. But that doesn't mean it was easy. Like, once we got married and we started going to personal development events, we a lot of times came up with like a similar style personality, like wanted to have massive success, wanted to go achieve a lot. And a lot of people would look at us and be like, oh, that must be like really hard, because like you can't have two cooks in the same kitchen and there must be like some type of like, you know, hitting heads and things like that.
And I think there was in the beginning.
Really?
Yeah, I think there was. I think that because, you know, I was single. Even though I was only 17, 18 years old, I was still very independent. And so when I met you, I was still very like dominant, go-getter, that type of person, because it was just me. And so when I met him, and he's extremely dominant, I had to, not lower, but I didn't have to be that dominant person as much as I used to when I was single. And I think that I had that, I don't know. I think when you're single, it's just different. And so with you, I didn't have to be as dominant and like crazy as I was back then.
Yeah, so I'd say the biggest thing for us outside of the tactics is that we've had like love and commitment is the foundation and God is the foundation of our relationship. And so we knew that going into it, that we were committed, right? There's a big difference between being together and just being in a relationship and being committed. It's kind of like the difference between a choice and a decision. A choice is like, I'm choosing to do this. I'm choosing to get married. Even though I'm going to say till death do us part, I'm going to say for richer, for poorer, like most people don't actually even believe that, or else mm-hmm. they get through the things in their relationship.
So true.
One of the big things that we found is that like commitment is something that you say and you create, right? I talk about choice, making a choice. Decision is like, this is final. I'm making a choice to do this, or I'm making a decision, which is final, like a line in the sand. I'm never going back. I'm cutting off all ties with this past life. And that's what I say commitment is, like doing what you said you were going to do after the feeling you said it and is gone. And what we've found together is inside of what people would say communication is such a big deal. Inside of communication, like the reason commitment's so cool is because let's say you love each other and then you get into a conflict. If you don't talk about it, ends up festering, ends up like turning into this big blow up. And I'm mm-hmm. sure everyone's experienced this before. And we've always been really big on communicating right away. And what we saw is that that commitment gets you to communicate. Because like when you don't have that commitment, then you're not going to go through the hard things. And what's so cool though is like when you get in the conflict, you have the commitment, so you talk about it. On the other side of talking about it, you know each other better. And on the mm-hmm. other side of knowing each other better, you love each other more. And you get to experience that feeling that you had before, but at a greater measure. Yet most people get stuck in the trenches of never communicating. So those are some of the big things that have worked with us. Yet if you don't have love in the relationship, you're not going to, you know, fall in love and stay together with like your roommate or something random like that. So I feel that there's something intangible that you almost can't explain mm-hmm. that is more important than anything else. It's that love for each other. It's keeping good thoughts towards each other.
Yeah.
Focus on writing down. Like if you don't feel connected, write down things that you're grateful for about your significant other. Then start telling them about that and practicing this back and forth. You'll see that love start to build again. And then the tactics on the other side, like communication and commitment and being in it for the long run. Those have been huge foundational things for us.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people get in the route that you're not on the same team and that your enemy is actually your significant other, that you're like, this is the person that's causing all the problems in my life and this is why I'm not happy and this is why we don't have XYZ is because of this person. And once you can get on the same page and really align with your spouse and be like, hey, we are on the same team, let's do this together. We're not fighting each other, we're fighting everything that's outside of us. Because, you know, this world and the stuff that happens to us in our society, it's trying to break you and your partner up. Like, it is literally trying to do that. And so you have to fight for your relationship and realize that you guys are on the same team. And how can you work together to, you know, build an empire and conquer and achieve your dreams together? Not, you know, thinking that this person's holding you back. And, you know, I mean, maybe some relationships are like that and, you know, you ended up not really choosing the right person. You're a completely different person. And maybe that is, but I think for most people, you know, you guys can commit and you guys can change and work it out together. And so daily, you know, Nicholas and I work together. And so every single day we have to be like, hey, we're on the same team. We're not fighting each other. We're fighting this problem or whatever it is. And, you know, when I get frustrated, I don't want him to think that it's him. And, you know, vice versa.
Yeah, and so it's easy to talk about this stuff and act like it's imperfect. And if you're new here, it wasn't always perfect. And I want you to touch on this, like to kind of wrap everything up is like, you know, we got married at 20 and 18, and then all of a sudden we went into business and then flopped. And then I was a carpet cleaner, and there was a lot of dynamics and times where I was either motivated or not motivated and all these different things. And so you kind of talk on like that experience and how we were able to overcome that, conquer it, and then also like build what we have now.
Yeah, so when we first got married, you know, we were both very motivated, but we were super, super young. We didn't really know what we were doing. And, you know, we just went out there and we built a business. We lost it all, like Nicholas said. And then, you know, he was trying to pursue his passion of motocross, you know, before he got too old. And then I was like, okay, well, I need to like pick up a side job. And, you know, I just started doing like a bunch of little jobs just to try to like, you know, make rent and everything. And he was out, you know, riding motocross. And so at the same time, I wanted to be that supportive wife that encouraged him to go after his dreams and, you know, not let, you know, money hinder him from doing that. And so I think that I wanted to be that supportive wife. I didn't want to be nagging. And so I supported him, but then it got to a point where I was like, okay, we need to change. This is not working. We keep going in debt and debt and debt. because we're not bringing in the money. And so then he had to start working with his dad, with the carpet cleaning company. And, you know, it was, so I just continued to try to like still build businesses and stuff. But I think that, you know, during that time we remained very close together still. And we didn't like fight about this stuff. I just try to encourage him and he always encouraged me. Even though it wasn't, you know, we weren't really working together during that time. And I could tell that the carpet cleaning thing definitely was not fulfilling him. And for men, they find a lot of their fulfillment in what they do for money. And so if they hate their job, if they hate whatever they're doing, they're really going to be in an unhappy place. And so, you know, for him, I could tell that he was a little unhappy with his current circumstances and it was getting him down and he was trying to find other outlets to make him happy, like golfing every single day and stuff. And then finally I just, you know, we both got on the same page and we're going to build this business together. We're not going to let life live us. We're going to live life to the fullest. And we both jumped on board together and it's been amazing ever since.
Totally. So it's been like a crazy journey together. It hasn't been perfect. And we discovered these things through the School of Hard Knock and then also investing in ourselves. And now with a baby on the way, it's made us go to that next level again, because now it's this different level of responsibility, right? You have this no responsibility almost when you're just by yourself. You have more responsibility instead of a relationship. And now we have more with a kid on the way and you start thinking about the future and what we're going to do and how things are going to change and pressure. A quote that everyone can live by is pressure doesn't create weakness, it exposes it.
Yeah.
More pressure, it'll burst something in this weakest point. It'll expose a weakness so that you guys can get over it so that you can be stronger. But don't think that just because there's a weakness that it was created, it was just exposed. It was always there and now you get a chance to become stronger and mend it together.
So one thing I want to add in is, you know, obviously we've been married for 7.5 years. And if you're watching this, we want to know how many years you have been in a relationship. So comment below how many years. So we've known each other for 8.5 years. We were together a year before we got married. But I want to know for Nicholas, like, what do you think is the thing that has kept it like exciting in our relationship and not boring? Because I think that some people who are in a relationship right now will be like, oh my gosh, like how can I like sustain this and like keep this relationship exciting and like fun? Because I think that guys get more bored, I don't know, in relationships than women do. And I think a lot of guys don't get married because they think that, how can I be with this one girl for like a long time? Like, I'm gonna get bored.
Yeah, I would say there's a quote out there that says, whatever you focus on increases. And so what are you focusing on? I talked about earlier, are you writing down what you're grateful for? Are you seeing the good things in your spouse? Or are you seeing just all the bad things? Are you talking to your friends about the bad things that they're doing? Or are you taking responsibility and talking about the good things that they're doing? Are you focusing on what are you giving attention to? And whatever you attend to is probably gonna grow. It's like in your garden. If you're sitting there attending to all these negative thoughts, then it's probably gonna contribute to the relationship. So always remember, like, why did you make the commitment in the first place? I don't know, there's just something about, and the reason I got married to Amanda was like, there's something about her that I just was attracted to. Like, I can look at her and be like, oh my gosh, like, aww. I'm so excited. Like, we talk about this all the time. We're like, I can't believe we get to be together. But again, that's what our focus is. Like, I've never seen her say something negative about me behind my back and start talking about all these things. We also have that upfront communication, so we don't allow things to fester. This has been something that I don't know where it came from, but it was something inside me that, though she's an internal processor a little bit more than I am, we've always communicated right off the bat. Even if it had to be slower or if I had to be quicker on, doesn't matter. We just said, hey, this is more important than anything else. And so I think one of the biggest things, again, is that we've allowed our relationship to be a higher priority than business or other people and other people's relationships, other people we're with. So if there's a problem here, we focus on that first before we go out and do the other stuff. And so many times, I think right now, I see people on social media with relationships, and it's kind of like anything else. I posted today, actually, in my stories and said something about that. Don't compare like your start from people's end, right? And then also, don't compare where you're at right now to someone else's highlight reel. Because the only people that post on social media, they're only going to post things that are good. Yeah. They have no obligation to post things that are bad either. So don't be upset about it. It's just when I was 60 pounds overweight, I wasn't posting about freaking eating Twinkies in the middle of the night because that was embarrassing. But you see people out there that make a ton of money that are freaking fat. Like, they're not fat because they're freaking eating perfectly and eating what they show on social media, they're probably fat because they're not moving enough, they're not optimizing their hormones, and again, there's a few people that may have an issue, yet the majority of them, like, I was fat because I was eating like I was fat. And so, like, when you compare your life to someone else's highlight reel, you're already going to fail, having that jealousy and envy of what's going on with other people, but on top of that, you have, like, the Instagram side of relationships, or the Facebook, or the whatever side of relationships, where people could literally fake it. I've seen people hire a model, take pictures with them for a photo shoot for their business. Nothing wrong with it. Mm-hmm. Just saying, if you're looking at yourself, like looking at that as a relationship, yeah. a good relationship isn't having a hot girl next to your side to take pictures with so you can post things in the captions and talk about your ride or die. And I see so much right now that that's what relationships are all mm-hmm. about. But like, that's not what's making relationships sustain every single day of the week.
Yeah, and I love the whole pressure doesn't create weakness, it exposes it. And I think that if you're going through any challenges in your relationship right now, actually be thankful for them, because it's going to make your relationship stronger. You know, if you're struggling financially, if like something's going on, like I think finances are definitely a huge piece of most relationship stress and you know, conflict. So just be thankful for that, because if you can make it through, you can be happy with each other and happy with the circumstances that you're in right now, you're going to be happy no matter what. I see a lot of people, you know, break up because they have this financial struggle, and it's like, wow, like your relationship really wasn't that strong because you let money get in the way of love. And I just feel like that's really, really sad in our society nowadays, because they just, you know, people give up when it gets hard. And you know, if that was every single movie we watched, there'd be a lot of freaking boring movies out there, because the best movies are the ones where people experience the most hardship and overcome them and succeed. And so if you just give up and, you know, give up when it's hard, then you'll never know the result of it.
I 100% agree. And yeah, it's just, that's how it is. If this was helpful to you, make sure to hit that thumbs up button and also leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to see more videos with Amanda and I. She has an awesome mommy channel as well. If you're a woman out there, go check out her channel. And yeah, relationship tips is something that I'm always looking to learn, because it's tough to do relationships in this world alone.